Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Sorry, we are late today because we had some technical problems. So inshallah, we didn't solve it, but inshallah, we work on it. Quickly, inshallah, because we have just 10 minutes. Our surah tonight should be Surah Ali Imran. And I want to just tell you about the connection between the two surahs, Al-Baqarah and Ali Imran. The connection is very powerful. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned the two surahs, Al-Baqarah and Ali Imran, and he called them Az-Zahrawayni. You know, the illuminated, subhanAllah, two chapters. Yani means anything Azhar means given light. So the beauty of these two surahs, that they given light, serenity, tranquility. SubhanAllah, these two surahs are amazing. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, they're going to come in the day of judgment as two clouds, غَمَامَتَيْنِ, two clouds or two shades in the day of judgment. In the other surah, Quran, the whole Quran going to come in the day of judgment. Some scholars said the reward of the Quran, some scholars said the Quran itself, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows better, but they're going to come in the day of judgment to intercede on your behalf in the front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. تَقْدُمُهُمَا الْبَقَرَ وَأَلِ عَمْرَان. In the front going to be Al-Baqarah and Ali Imran. So Al-Baqarah and Ali Imran are very important surah. All Quran is, you know, are important. All surahs are important. But these two surahs are more important than any other surahs in the Quran. And the similarity between the three surahs, Al-Fatiha, Al-Baqarah, Ali Imran. The first thing, look at the end of Surah Al-Fatiha, it ends by dua. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. Look at the end of Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملت. Look at the end of Surah Ali Imran. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the beautiful hadith came home one night. And he told Aisha radiallahu anha, Aisha, I'm going to ask your permission to let me pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala this night. And Aisha said, O Prophet of Allah, wallahi, inni la uhibbu qurbaka walakinni uhibbu ma tuhibbu. I love to be close from you, but at the same time, I love for you what you love for yourself. He prayed sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Subhanallah, Aisha described the prayer of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at that night. She said, فقرأ حتى ابتلت لحيته, till he got his subhanallah beard wet, and وقرأ حتى ابتلت ثيابه, till his subhanallah his clothes were wet from his tears sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and then he made sujood and he made the floor wet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, till fajr salah, till Bilal came to wake him up. Of course, he never slept sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Prophet of Allah, as-salatu khayru min al-nawm, come to pray, he said, I never slept, subhanallah. He said something sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, unzilat alayya al-layla ayat, some ayat of al-Quran was revealed to me. Woe to him, the one who recited without understanding. يعني ويل لمن قرأها ولم يتدبرها. And he recited, inna fi of the two surahs, you know, the greatest name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ismullah al-a'zam. In the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you want to know what is the name of Allah, the greatest name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, look at the ayah, inna fi khalqi samawati wal ard, in Surah Al-Baqarah, and look at in the beginning of Surah Ali Imran, Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum, and also Ayatul Kursi, the queen of the whole verses, ayat of Al-Quran Al-Kareem, Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum, la ta'akudhu sinatu wa la nawm. This is Surah, we have a lot to say about Surah Ali Imran, but the most important ayah, in my opinion, this is the core, the heart of the whole Surah Ali Imran. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, ittaqu allaha haqqa tuqati, fear Allah as he deserves to be feared, wa la tamutunna, and don't die, illa wa antum muslimun, except in the state of Islam. Islam as Muslim. To die as a Muslim, you need to practice Islam all your life. The reason is, you do not know when you're going to die. So you need to be a Muslim all your life. To make sure that you're going to die as a Muslim, you need to practice Islam all your life. Look what Surah Al-Baqarah told you, how to practice Islam. Yesterday we were talking about Surah Al-Baqarah, how to pray, how to fast, how to give charity, how to make hajj. In Surah Al-Baqarah yesterday, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about life and death in Surah Al-Baqarah. Here also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about so many things in aqidah, in heart, in iman, in faith. You know, that wafd, you know, allegation from the Nasara, Najran, you know, they came, Christian people came to argue with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about Jesus alayhi sallam. And Allah has revealed to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, those people who said Allah is the father of Jesus because Jesus came without father, a father, what about Adam? Ask them the same question. What are you going to say about Adam? Adam, you know, the likeness of Isa, Jesus is like Adam alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created him from dust and he says be, and he being a human being. Kun fayakun. An amazing. Allah, this is one of the great things in the Quran to think about. But when you came to the ayah, تَقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, don't die except in the state. It's better for you. Why? Because if you're going to die as non-Muslim, you know where you're going to go. You know, so you, if you're going to choose for yourself to die as a Muslim, you need to practice Islam all your life. How to practice Islam? Listen to Allah's guidance. From the beginning we said what? Ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim. In Surah Al-Baqarah it was so clear that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided us through Surah Al-Baqarah. But here in Surah Al-Imran also from the beginning, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, some people, when they decide to follow the guidance of Allah, they will have so many fitna, so many trials in their life. From the beginning of the surah, Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala, زُيِّنَ لِلنَّاسِ حُبُّ الشَّهَوَاتِ مِنَ النِّسَاءِ وَالْبَنِينَ وَالْقَنَاطِيرِ الْمُقَنْطَرَةِ مِنَ الذَّهَبِ وَالْفِضَّةِ وَالْخَيْلِ الْمُسَوَّمَةِ وَالْأَنْعَامِ وَالْحَرْثِ. Look at this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, he decorated subhanahu wa ta'ala in this world life to have kids, to have relationship with your spouses, okay, to have money, especially of course gold and silver, and you know, and also to have horses, to have money, fortune, subhanAllah, in this world life. This is fitna. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in other surah, Surah Al-Munafiqun, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, la tulhikum amwalukum wala awladukum an dhikrillah. Don't be distracted by your money or your children, you know, from mentioning the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ أَوْنَبِّئُكُمْ, should I tell you what is better than that? Yes, oh Allah, what is better? We think if somebody has, mashallah, wives, has kids, has money, properties, authority. Well, khayl al-musawa means authority also. This is, he gains or he owns the whole life. What is better than that? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you will fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لِلَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِيَ الْأَنْهَارِ. Paradise, gardens, you know, the river is going to run beneath these gardens. خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا is not for a temporary time. خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا, comparing to the life. Life is short and temporary. But in the hereafter, Jannah is going to be eternal, subhanAllah, life. Forever, no end. SubhanAllah, it is endless time in Jannah. خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا. Not just that. وَأَزْوَاجٌ مُطَهَّرَةٌ. What is better than that? Allah said something. وَرِضْوَانٌ مِّنَ اللَّهِ. If Allah will be satisfied with you, this is better than everything. That's why when you read Surah Ali Imran, search where exactly, you know, the ayat tells me how to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will be amazed by the ayat which is talking about following the guidance of Allah. Again, subhanallah, in Surah Al-Baqarah, قُلْ إِنَّ هُدَى اللَّهِ هُوَ الْهُدَى. Indeed, Allah's guidance is the best guidance. Here in Al-Imran, قُلْ إِنَّ الْهُدَى هُدَى اللَّهِ. The best guidance ever, the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no comparison between the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and any other guidance. I was speaking, you know, subhanAllah, very quickly because we have a technical subhanAllah problems, and you, if you can see Brother Ashraf behind the camera holding the cable, subhanAllah, make dua to Brother Ashraf, make dua to Brother Abdel Halim and Brother Amir and Brother Hafiz, and for me, please make dua inshallah. Ramadan Mubarak, inshallah. We're gonna continue tomorrow inshallah talking about Surah An-Nisa inshallah. Jazakum Allahu khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.